Hello friends, we are trying to cope with the COVID-19 lockdowns just now. Many of us feel so very frustrated and we pass on this frustration to others unwittingly. If we are feeling so frustrated, we need to think how much more our children would feel frustrated because they are just bundles of joy. And therefore, I would like to give you a few tips today to deal with your children and help them cope with this lockdown. Not only that, be sure that these suggestions that I give can be used for their holidays, their vacations as well. First of all, make sure that you do not have any kind of negativity in your talk. When we feel frustrated, we tend to grumble, we find fault with everyone. Let us avoid that to begin with. Secondly, we tend to be individualistic and our children try to follow us. You know it very well how your children will be sitting with their mobile phones staring at you know what. And therefore, we need to make sure that our children don't get hooked to the mobile or to video games. Thirdly, what I suggest is help your children plan a schedule for the day as well as a schedule for the week. This is going to help your children. And I said, make sure that they prepare this timetable under your supervision. It's not you preparing a timetable for them. We are very much used to that. But no, ask them to prepare a timetable from the time they wake up till the time they go to bed. They prepare a timetable for themselves. You could also set certain goals and objectives that you're going to achieve for the week or even the daily objectives. These objectives would end with some kind of a reward or some incentive that they are going to have at the end of the day or end of the week. While preparing the schedule, what you need to take care of is striking a balance. Striking a balance between your work and play. When I say work, it is the household chores. There are so many. They could help out in the kitchen. They could do the laundry. They could help out in doing the dishes. They could do so many other things in the house. And that they need to do, not just because you want the things done, but because they learn responsibility. They learn to be part of a household. They become part of a family by doing so. Secondly, there should be also fun-loving activities. When I say play, I'm not restricting myself to games alone, but there could be so many activities that they can spend time with. You will also expect them to spend some time in serious study. While they do a little serious study during vacations and during lockdowns, don't expect them to spend hours together with study. They could also have lighter academic activities, like for instance, finding new vocabulary words or doing some science experiments, puzzles perhaps. There are so many things that they could do, and if you have a computer at home, so much the better. They will have so many academic activities which are much lighter than the regular study, which they can get involved in. Thirdly, strike a balance between indoor and outdoor activities. Most of the activities that I suggested just now are all indoor activities, and during a lockdown, perhaps you will have to speak about indoor activities. But when they are on vacations, and even perhaps to some extent during the lockdown, they could have some outdoor activities like gardening or playing outside in your campus with their companions, with the neighbors, with the other children in your family. And this is important. They need to go out. They need to touch the earth while they do gardening. You could also strike a balance between individual activities as well as group activities, which you do together as families. Some of our children are temperamentally inclined to work alone. When they are with some book or while they're working on the computer or their personal study, they like it, they enjoy it, and they spend a lot of time doing things individually, personally. But there are times we need to go to them to mingle with others, do things together with the family, with their friends, companions, neighbors, whatever. There are other children who are temperamentally interpersonal. They spend a lot of time with others. They like outdoor activities. They like group activities. Now, those are the children probably we need to goad them to sit at their desk for a little while and concentrate. And when they do that, they learn a lot. Finally, strike a balance between their leisure time and rest, as well as the activities. They need to take a little time of rest. Rest is very important. Not spending the whole night watching a movie and then get up late in the morning, the whole schedule will get disrupted. A final word is about evaluation and prayer. Every day has to be evaluated. You need to teach your children to evaluate the day and look at two important things. One is how the objectives of the day and the plan was fulfilled. If there was a particular plan, we need to say, was it fulfilled? Did you do all things right? Not to feel guilty about not having done it, but to feel good about it and always strive to do better. There is also another aspect of what do you feel about the day? Do you feel happy about yourself? You know, you need to pat your back once in a way and say, okay, I'm doing good. I'm improving. And they need it. Children need a pat on the back. After having evaluated the day, to say a small little prayer, thanking God for all the wonderful things that they have experienced during the day. Very important to have that sentiment of gratitude towards God. You could start the day with prayer, but more importantly, you'd end the day with deep gratitude to God for all that has happened during the day. Friends, these are a few tips that I am suggesting how we could help your children cope with the lockdowns and the vacations. If you follow this, I am sure your children will grow up to be wonderful citizens, good, responsible adults. God bless you.